Not too long ago, I took a flight through the Tampa International Airport, and obviously there have been many changes to air travel, from having to wear masks to social distancing between the seats. But there's one change that I noticed at TSA. You know how when you get up to that checkpoint and they check your boarding pass along with your license just to make sure you are who you say you are? Well, that didn't exactly happen for me. They didn't check my boarding pass, only my license. And I was kind of confused, wondering how did they know where I was flying that day if they weren't going to check my boarding pass? Well, I forgot about the incident, went on my way, but a few weeks later, a coworker came up to me with the same story. No checking of the boarding pass, only his license. And TPA has quite the reputation. They've been known to make TSA's annual list for most firearms intercepted at airports nationwide. So we wondered if not checking boarding passes could be an increased security concern. So I headed out to TPA to meet with TSA to see what exactly was going on. About 30,000 travelers pass through TPA every day.
Of course, we're still recovering from 2020 COVID, and our numbers actually fell by right about 50% from 2019. Right now, we're about 95% of where we were in 2019. We expect that the holidays could be big numbers for us, but with the resurgence of COVID, with the Delta variant, it's difficult for us to project.
The average wait time at those security checkpoints is only about 10 minutes, and TSA actually says that they haven't seen a wait time longer than 30 minutes at TPA in the last 3 years. And new technology could improve on those wait times and cut down some extra steps.
We have the credentialing authentication technology called the CAT machine, which is a step up from our boarding pass scanner. When CAT looks at the identification, it of course brings up the picture and it validates for the officer that that's who they're talking to. And of course, part of the process is the officer will ask a passenger to remove their mask for just a moment so that they can actually validate that face matching the ID. Now you can use your identification to real-time verify that you are who you say you are, and it also verifies that you actually have a flight.
In other words, no need to show your boarding pass. Of course, you'll still have to show it at the gate or at the terminal entrance, but not to the TSA agent at the initial checkpoint. But if you have kids, they're covered.
Minors with their parents aren't required to have an ID, but they're with their family. So what we do in that case is we just use the boarding pass scanner to make sure that their boarding pass is valid.
The new tech removes human error almost entirely.
When you take the human being out of the process, there's less of a chance that there's going to be a mistake made. You're going to miss somebody with a different name, or the picture's not going to match, say from a passport. You know, the name looks the same, but the picture's different. Catching a fraudulent identification is actually pretty difficult.
Thorough security is an absolute must. And in 2019, TSA at TPA intercepted 87 firearms. And that actually landed the airport the number 10 spot on the list for the most firearms found at security checkpoints nationwide. And numbers this year could put the airport on track to make the list again.
To date this year, we've had 78. We've still got 6 weeks to go, so we may have as many firearms this year as we've had in the past.
Having a firearm at an airport means getting law enforcement involved. And depending on the state of the firearm, if it's loaded, means you could be going to jail.
Law enforcement takes over the weapon, and they take over the process of discussing it with the passenger. If they have a concealed carry, they're usually given the opportunity to put it in their vehicle or give it to a companion that's not traveling. If they don't have a concealed carry, they usually leave here accompanied by law enforcement and end up with an arrest.
Not to mention the fines you'll be facing.
Even if you don't get arrested when you bring a firearm to the checkpoint, we do investigate every case with a civil action for regulatory compliance. The fines for those events can get upwards of $13,000.
TSA says these incidents are usually just accidents. People often forget to take them out of their bags before traveling. But it shows the need for continuously updated security, starting at that initial checkpoint. The CAT machines are being phased in, so you may still have to scan your boarding pass, but you can expect to see them at all checkpoints across TPA by December.
We're doing this for you, for your protection. And that process requires a partnership between my officers and the passengers. So bring your patience and leave your temper at home.
So yes, the TSA is still verifying who you are and if you're flying that day, even without looking at your boarding pass. If you have any random questions that you'd like us to look into, you can email me at mjones@10tampabay.com or find me on Twitter @katiejonestv.